Oh, look at that. Some bitch is still alive, even. Hardy as can be, just like a shark, too, ain't they? Oh. Ooh, Molly wants her pieces. Spoiled brat. Y'all can see that size of them. It's still alive. This is our tool of choice, Rapala. Not just any of the Rapalas, though. Get the signature series. The Martin signatures, this sumbitch holds a good edge. The rest of them ain't no better than any of the rest. Thing to remember, these fish are boneless. Cartilage fish. So I'll roll it up here. What we're going to do, you see this color transition from the gray to the white. We're going to go right across there, down just past dorsal fin. We're going to come up to the dorsal, cut this side of the dorsal, and right along the back of where a backbone would be. Now, where most people mess up is the head. You see there's a plate right here. Now you can kind of see the edge of that plate right there. Well, we're going to come all the way up to here, across, and we're going to come around that edge and around this gill plate down to that line. And we're going to get that whole thing right there is going to be one fillet, and I shit you not, it's going to be that thick. It's going to be that thick when it comes off there. So literally end up cutting the fillet, you know, slicing it in half so you only got an inch thick and you can get it to cook right. Water running here and wash this pig real quick. Ain't eating the skin, but it makes it a little easier to work with. And anybody not familiar with these, this is basically a freshwater toothless shark. The skin texture is the same as a shark. You can feel like a sandpaper grain. The meat consistency is like shark. But if you smoke it right, you can get more of a halibut flavor out of it. The stuff smokes up phenomenal. Now, just for the sake of ease, I cut these extra flaps off. Just get them out of the way. So I got to come around this bone here. You know, come down here, cut the tail, and like I said, right up that lateral line. Okay, I knew this was a female. Okay, we got a shit ton of eggs in this girl. Shit ton. I mean, I am not kidding. And this is like caviar egg right here. Look at this. I'm going to go ahead and open her up here so y'all can see this. This is why, right here, what I'm going to show you is why the state will voluntarily take your fish and process it for you. Because the state turns around and they sell the roe on the market, on the international market for caviar production. It's illegal for citizens, privates to sell it, but you can make your own caviar. But see, look at that egg. Look at that egg sac. That's all black caviar roe. That right there, you figure that shit goes anywhere from $300 to $1,500 an ounce. And there's probably about 4.5 pounds of caviar in this fish. About 4.5 pounds of roe. Up that spine, top side of the dorsal, just right on through. Right up to the head. See, now, you can feel a hard spot there. around here. Around that piece there. And there's one big ass fillet. Now the reason it's bloody is because I severed the main core of the spinal cartilage. So that just washes off, no big deal. And see, there's all your caviar. So if you want to make some money, this right here is why these fish were poached and we're only allowed to keep two per year. In Oklahoma, we're only allowed to keep two per year. From what I understand, Arkansas lets them keep three per day or some shit like that. Which, that's cool. Arkansas ain't that far away, but I'm not going to pay for an out-of-state license just to run up there for a day and get a couple of these. One of these produces more than enough meat for a family. There we go. You can see two massive fillets. And you can see that thickness there. Bigger. My thumb is an inch wide. I got 2.5 inches, almost 3 inch thick of fillet. And that's down at the belly. So now I'll rinse my hands real quick and grab my dog food bag to get rid of the carcass. That's it. Sit here, clean off the table. gonna throw the cutting board up here. I'm gonna take that skin off, and I'm gonna show you easiest, quickest way to get rid of the red meat. Where all you gotta do is give these just a quick rinse on each side, and they're ready for putting on your seasoning and throwing on the smoker. This is a very, very fatty fish. Very fatty fish. They run deep, they like running water. They will hold up in pools when water gets low. But you'll find they stack up in deep water. And I mean, they stack up, you know, 50, 60, 70, 80 fish in a small hole. So you find them, once you're on them, it don't take long to wear yourself out. Doesn't take long at all to be plumb 100% worn out. And all this fat's gonna come off. See this dark meat here? There's a line of that shit right down the lateral line on the outside, like a catfish and other fish, that changes the taste and flavor of the meat horribly. I mean, a really, really bad way. Now, I'm gonna cut these up in smaller pieces just so they're easier to work with. Cutting board. I'm ready to start working with these bad boys. Get this sucker trimmed down. I'm just gonna take this fat right off. Yeah. Now watch what happens when I cut that away. Look at that meat. Just white as can be. Oh man, this stuff is phenomenal. Phenomenal meat. Here out to the edge. Boom. So here's that dark meat I'm telling you about. I'm gonna take this little slice here off. It looks like shit. There we go. Get under that red meat. That's our lateral line. It kind of V's down in there, kind of deep. So get under it, turn it around, come back. Yep. There's one. Here, dog. All right. Okay, there's one ready for the smoker. Just give that a quick rinse, a little bit of rub, good to go. Dog. Gunner, chief. Yep. Good stuff for dogs. Good for their coats. Good for winter. Circle around. Right, that's where I hooked it. Broadsided. I'm going to cut a little bit excess off this one because got traumatized meat there. A lot of blood in it. Voila. Now because of the texture of that skin, these things will kill a blade pretty quick. Keep your stones. You see, I got a two-sided 6-inch. I got my ceramic. And then I got the one that came with it, which is nice for quick and easies. I prefer my ceramic. Piece. Dog. There's a good one here. Nice thick piece. Oh, hit dog in the head with that one. Sliding around. See how we do without it. Oh yeah, look at that. Bam, piece of cake. Oops, wrong pile. Around here, little V cut. Just get that red meat from the lateral line out of there. Good. Nope. Oh, damn, that looks good meat. Wash that shit out of there. Still didn't go deep enough. I mean, these suckers are thick. No problem. You see how thick that stuff is. Got some weight to it. Hey, look, new trick. Cut them free. I'm a southpaw. I'm gonna get my shit turned the right direction. Try not to waste too much meat, because all that is just stomach liner. You know, for the stomach cavity. This shit really fatty, so you notice my blade's dragging the meat. Well, it's because the amount of fat in this stuff. You talk about high in omega-3 healthy stuff. You get more nutrition out of the shit from one of these fish than you can from fucking half a dozen tilapia. I could wash that out, but there's so much meat here, I'm not worried about it. Gonna come in above that lateral line again. Yeah, it's dragging too much on the meat. After this piece, we'll wash our blade a little bit. Turn off my water, I'm gonna be standing in the lake. Bit back there. Happy dogs over there. Okay, now this, you can see that red meat line. So that's what I'm trying to get rid of, so that I got nice pretty meat like that. And didn't quite get it on that one. Suzanne. this way. That meat's thickest in the middle, so we'll go ahead and split them. That red shit thick in the middle. We're going to split them down the middle. We can trim it at an angle. Look at that. Didn't hardly get any. There you go. Dogs? Huh? Dogs? Alright. Gunner? White meat, dog. That liner there, get that off there, no problem. A little more liner here, trim it off, dog. Some here, top, dog. Turn that sucker, come in from the top side of it. Across we go. Oh, look at that. Didn't go deep enough. No problem. Just meat. Dog. Molly, you got a piece, you bitch. Let him have it. There you go. Here, Goober. Attaboy. We can take a little bit of that off the inside. Make that a little prettier. Oh, look at that. Success. Ain't that pretty? That looks much better. Boom. Very nice. Yep. Still got some of that shit in there, damn it. Not for sure I went deep enough. Pain in the ass sometimes. That was a good one. Right. Another shot of water, my hand, and one piece left. We'll rinse them off. And here's our last piece. That belly liner off of there. A little bit of fat along the top, dorsal. Molly, get out of there. I'll take a second to introduce you all to the kids. Molly and Gunner taking off like a bat out of hell. Okay, and then here's Chief. He was a latecomer, so he's gonna get a nice big one. We'll give him a nice big one. And that's it. That spoonbill is all trimmed. Oop. Hey, got one in there. Didn't take skin off anymore. That's all right. Yeah, we just remedy that real quick here. Hey, no self-service, boy. There you go. Kick rocks. One. Get. Want that one? There you go. We'll get it. All right, gonna cut this feed, and we'll see y'all just a bit. Once I got meat rinsed and I'm ready to season it and fire it on the smoker. Or, yeah, what the hell. I'm going to just rinse my tray and do this real quick. Damn, that water's cold. Now, to keep in mind, each of these pieces is about the size of my fist. This ain't no little small amount, shy amount of meat. I'll smoke this up and I'll vacuum seal some of it. This meat will last me. I'll have smoked spoonbill snacking for the next couple weeks off of one fish. Piece of trimming. Keep my finger, dog. This piece could use a little more trim. It don't bother me a bit to trim, because nothing goes to waste. I got a bunch of puppies. They take all them scraps gladly. Gladly take them scraps, no problem. There you are. Yeah. All right. There you go. There's spoonbill playing 101. We're ready for the smoker. The nice thing, you noticed all the way through this whole process, there's no guts to deal with. I don't have no mess when I'm done trimming. Skin side of the fillets goes in the bag. Dogs get all the fat and red meat trims. That's it. All I got to do is wipe off my table and I'm done. 100%. Voila. Well, hope y'all found it educational, or at least entertaining. Prefer to be able to help somebody else out, figure out how to do something, or, you know, like I said, if anything, keep you entertained for a few minutes. You having a bad day? Well, come listen to my foul mouth and watch me play with my meat. I'll entertain you. All right, y'all. I'm going to get the rest of this table cleaned off and go get my grill started. We'll be right back with y'all in just about 20, 25 minutes. Bye.